Before long, I dropped when I awoke.
Welcome, everyone, to an exciting broadcast of college basketball here on 2K Sports. Some great action in store tonight, seeing some of the best and brightest young players on the hardwood. Along with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. We'll see Villanova taking on the Kansas Jayhawks.
There is no feeling like a packed house on a college campus. You can just feel the electricity in the air as two major colleges go head-to-head on the hardwood.
And even though this game isn't a must-have,
Freak in at the four spot. He's out there with Oubre, and it's Gaines in at the five. Beal, the pass to Cooper, puts up a three. No good. And Kansas the other way now.
Boy, some really big names have come out of the Kansas Jayhawks program into the NBA. A pair of first overall picks in their history. Believe it or not, Wilt Chamberlain wasn't one of them.
And for Villanova, they've got Miller. Cooper is out there with Bryant. And it's Ilgauskas in at the four.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the deep.
Beal with it. He's picked up by Lee. Miller with a wide open look. Bangs home the trifecta. Miller's got his first 3 points of the game.
What are they thinking, leaving him with all that space out there? Do they not know, have they not heard, that this guy is unbelievable? That's a layup for him.
Villanova leading by five. Miller with a screen on Lee. There's Beal with a three. That's good.
That's two straight quick three-pointers they've allowed.
Defense just not reacting with enough aggressiveness.
Now, here's Oubre, covered by Miller. Oubre kicks it to Gaines. Pass to Freak. Shoots. The basket is good. The assist from Gaines.
One thing with Freak that we know is he makes sure he gets his shots up no matter what. One way or another, he's going to get his workout in, and that's why so many are confident that he'll continue to improve.
Part of it is that he has a twin sister who actually taught him how to play ball. She helped him develop his game and become the player he is today. Pretty nice to have a sibling willing to help you develop your skill set on the court.
Daniels is checked in for the Jayhawks. Villanova also with a sub. Foster's checked in. Here's Gaines. And it's Foster with the rebound. Gaines has gotten just one of his four attempts from the floor tonight. An intentional foul committed, but for what purpose, Greg? I'm not sure.
A scene of confusion right there. I can't imagine why he thought it was a good idea to foul there.
Villanova shooting their seventh and eighth. And that concludes the first half. Hello, welcome back. This is College Basketball on 2K Sports. And if you're just tuning in, this is Kevin Harlan along with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg as we get set for the second half.
And guys, without a doubt, it's been a rough go so far here for Freak and his team. They just can't find anything to capitalize on consistently thus far.
And Greg, I'm anticipating plenty of adjustments from the coach, but I tell you what, when it comes down to what happens in the second half, it's about the players executing. A few quick baskets right out of the gate, and it's anybody's game.
Freak, he's in at power forward. He's out there with Oubre. Hi, everyone, and welcome to this broadcast of college basketball on 2K Sports. The action doesn't get much better than two of the most dynamic teams in college basketball going at it on the hardwood. Hi, this is Kevin Harlan, joined by my partners Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg. We've got the Kansas Jayhawks and the Texas Longhorns.
And you know, guys, we go back many years broadcasting college games, and it never gets old. Every big-time player makes a name for themselves at the college level, and we could see that again on display here tonight.
Well, with a guy like Freak suiting up, you know that there are going to be scouts watching his every move, but you look at the roster of both of these teams, and they're really loaded with talent.
So let's take a look at the starters for the Kansas Jayhawks. Freak in at power forward. He's out there with Oubre, and it's Gaines in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Here's Ford, rebounded by the Jayhawks.
Nice effort anyway to change his shot and get around the defender, maybe next time. And Kansas always seems to be in title contention. I mean, the program does a great job of finding tough players and having a system that fits them best. Rarely are they not a title contender. Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there, earned those free throws.
The Jayhawks shooting their first free throws of this. He's off on the second.
Well, in Texas, the Longhorns are known for their football history, actually all over the country. They have an impressive basketball alumnus list, too, though. A lot of pros have come out of Texas. There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
Here's Lee. The pass to Oubre. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Just so fast. I mean, it's like trying to stop a train when he's coming in for the slam.
Hudson is out there with Turner. Then it's Ellis. Then there's Doherty. And it's Edwards in at the point guard position. Here's Oubre. The teardrop falls in. Oubre's got his second bucket of the night.
Now there's something for the top 10 highlight reel right there. A layup can be just as sweet and as pretty as...
And the second half of basketball is about to get underway, folks. Welcome back to this broadcast of college basketball here on 2K Sports.
Guys, you know, it's been a close one thus far. Both teams have had strong stretches, but neither team has really been able to take control of the game to this point.
And guys, this is kind of like a boxing match, a bit of a feeling out period thus far. The second half, we should see more things open up, and that should benefit star players like Freak, who will get more quality opportunities.
And for Texas, they've got Edwards, also Ellis out there. Doherty out there with Turner. And it's Ford in at the power forward position. Doherty, no luck.
Well, what appeared to be an easy 2 points just never materialized.
Well, one thing about Kansas is that they love their basketball. Jayhawks have long been synonymous with being a powerhouse college program.
One of the true blue bloods, if you will, in college basketball. I mean, they've been relevant and in contention for a very long time. They were winning titles before any official organization was put in place.
Here's Freak. Off target from outside.
It's been a cold spell for them coming out of the half, missing their first three shots. A tough start.
And Doherty kicks to Edwards from the line. Takes a three. And Texas hits again from deep.
They're going back to the three-point shot over and over and over.
And they may have found the Achilles heel of this defense. That was their ninth straight point from beyond the arc.
They get it back, and it's thrown down hard with both hands.
And that's an example of willpower right there, guys. I mean, grabbing the offensive rebound and then going back to him strong.
And GA, in a close game like this where every possession is critical, that could prove to be a very big one.
Boy, it sure could, Kevin. I mean, he salvaged two big points for them off that miss.
And the foul called on Freak. And so he's picked up. Hi, everyone. We've got a great night of college basketball hoops in store for you tonight. It's a big matchup and some big-time energy in this building, and we're glad to have you with us. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. We'll see the Louisville Cardinals taking on the Kansas Jayhawks.
And the thing you love about collegiate sports, the passion, the energy, I mean, the competitiveness and that hunger and drive to succeed and show what you have, it's really always a marvel to watch.
No doubt about it, Greg. And seeing these players out here tonight, I remember how the love for the game of basketball in those formative years when I was playing college was so invaluable. I mean, the experience you gain with excellent coaching and mentorship at this level, really a huge part of where you go with your talent.
Now let's take a look at Louisville's opening lineup. We've got Rozier. White is out there with Payton. Then there's Sanders. And it's Mack in at the five spot. Here's Rozier. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Defensively, that possession better not start a trend because they just handed him 2 points.
Here's Freak. Offensive rebound. Boom, he chains it straight down.
And just scrapes and claws for that offensive rebound and doesn't take any chances there with the put.
And G.A. strong work all around. And the rebound and the stuff both. Wow.
Yep, he stayed with it all the way and got his reward at the end.
And guys, over the years, Louisville has had a reputation of being a high-flying offense. You know they'll play at a high tempo and create a lot of chances. It's just what has worked for the program for so long. Really aggressive play there, taking it to the rack against the big fella.
You know, Greg, aggressiveness is really the only option when you're on the wrong side of the size equation.
And the shot is good. Freak's got his first bucket in this one.
And you see a lot of players who are very talented play with a me-first approach. That is not the case with Freak. He doesn't try and attract any unnecessary attention and just focuses on playing his game.
Kansas trails by 5. On the court for Louisville, White is out there with Thomas. Then there's Sanders. And it's Mack, and it's center. So it's Louisville now, and we have an intentional foul there, G.A. And we welcome you back to college basketball here on 2K Sports as we get ready to get going for the second half of play.
Guys, we had a tight game through the first half. I think we'll see more of the same coming out of the break.
And it's just going to take one big run for one of these teams to establish control. If we can get hot, his team has a great chance of coming away with the victory.
And for Kansas, Freak in at the four spot. He's out there with Oubre, and it's Gaines in at the center position. Cardinals leading by 5. Lee with the steal. And a wide-open look for Freak. It's rebounded by Louisville. Max got 6 rebounds here tonight. Payton, right side, fires from 14. Rebound by Gaines.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take. Nice move and finish. I think the halftime break really gave him a second one.
And the foul called on Freak. Welcome, everyone. It's the night we've all been waiting for. The college tournament finale is upon us. And for two teams, this marks the end of an incredible journey. And the energy is contagious here in the building. Hi, this is Kevin Harlan, joined by my partners, Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg. We'll see the Wisconsin Badgers taking on the Kansas Jayhawks.
Kevin, this is the night where we are going to see some intense basketball. High energy, lay it all out on the line for college hoops. Everything these young players have worked towards their entire life comes down to this exact moment.
And you can bet, Clark, that each and every player here tonight feels the importance of this game like no other in their lives, really. A big key in coming through in a big game like this is how well you can compose yourself. How do you handle the pressure of the big stage? We'll find out soon enough which of these teams has the ability to harness all of that raw energy and focus on getting the job done.
Let's check out Wisconsin's starting lineup. We've got Hawkins. He's out there with Hill. Kaminsky out there with Decker. And it's Evans in at the power forward position.
And with any championship game, you know that every player's going to have their heart racing for the first few minutes. That's just natural. That's adrenaline. They'll need to remain calm, though, and let the game come to them and kind of ease into it.
And one guy, guys, I'll keep an eye on in this one is Freak. He is the consummate leader for his team. He can come out strong and play his game while keeping his intensity level up. It'll be just what they need to claim the title.
Hawkins with it. He's picked up by Lee. Hill has the open look. No good from outside. And so here's Kansas. It's a three-point game.
And not many people know this, but the Badgers do have one college title in their trophy case. Won the tournament back in 1941. A different time back then, but a title nevertheless.
There's Freak. And the Jayhawks again can't hit.
And boy, has he been struggling big time here in the quarter.
And so they foul intentionally.
Yeah, not sure.
And welcome back. We're just about ready to get going with the second half of a historical championship game. For those just tuning in, this is Kevin Harlan, pleased to be alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony as we get set to watch how the college basketball season will end.
And in a championship game like this one, guys, you would have expected a close battle. I don't think either side is going to be able to run away and hide in this one.
And Greg, tight games like this are where legends are born. I mean, if a player like Freak can come up huge in this final half of play, he'll anchor himself in school history as one of the greats to ever play the game.
Freak in at the four spot. He's out there with Oubre, and it's Duncan in at the shooting guard. And for the Badgers, we've got Kaminsky. Hawkins is out there with Hill. Then it's Decker, and it's Evans in at the four spot. Freak, he's in a power forward. He's out there with Oubre, and it's Lee in a point.
You know, one of the big questions on everybody's mind in this game is whether or not Freak will stay on for another year.
And so the Jayhawks take the win. Such a special moment for these kids. All the hard work they put in, all the pressure, Greg, they've been under all tournament long. This is pure elation. Being able to call themselves now champions.
And Kevin, from the players, the rest of the students watching, I mean, this is something that can never be taken from you. They will always have this moment in history to reflect upon.
And it's such a punishing path to this moment. I mean, you look back on all the close calls along the way as the field gets whittled down round by round. I mean, they survived quite the gauntlet to get to this moment.
Indeed, a very special moment. And that's going to do it for us. I'm Kevin Harlan. It was a pleasure to be with you all season long.
Oh. Hello?
Hey, Ma, it's me.
Hey, Frequency.
I got you on speakerphone.
Okay, your sister there?
Hey, Mama, I'm right here.
Hey, baby, how you doing?
I'm fine.
You bet's here too, Mama.
Hi, Mama. How you doing? I'm fine.
Does she have to be here?
Yes. Mr. Pagnotti, the agent I was telling you about, he's in the room too.
How you doing, ma'am?
I'm good. Nice to meet you.
What a pleasure to finally meet the Queen Mother, this young, talented man, even if only by telephone.
That's sweet. Hang on, Frequency. Here comes your father.
Hi.
Hey, sorry I'm late. Hope everyone's well.
How you doing, Mr.
Hey, Bob?
I'm doing good.
So let's get to it.
Yeah, let's do this. We all know why we're here. This meeting is strictly confidential, 100% off the record. Didn't happen. We weren't even here. Capisce? Capisce means understand in Italian. Capisce?
Capisce.
Freak insisted that I have his entire family here. And I think it's great that he has a good support system around him. I've been doing this a very long time, and I work with some of the best. Now, let me rephrase that. I work with the best, and the best always seem to have a great support system around them. A family, if you will, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So let's cut to the chase. Leaving college early now and entering this year's NBA draft is the right move right now. And when you sign with me, Dom Pagnotti, as your agent, I will make sure you are well taken care of. I will make sure you are protected. With this freaking and vibing, I love it. Freaking and vibing. This freaking and vibing thing you do when you get hot freak, we're gonna make you more money off the court than you will on.
We already have endorsements and things like that in mind, so.
Cece, I said we because we're gonna do this together. We're a team. We're team freak. But freak, you need to be in the league first, right? That's why I'm here.
No, yeah, I hear you, Mr. Pagnotti, but like I told you before, I already promised my parents 4 years of college. That's a plan, man.
That's right.
Plans change, freak.
Listen, in life and in basketball, you need to adapt and change to the situation at hand. Now, even if you have the greatest coach and they draw up the greatest play and all the X's and O's make perfect sense on paper, you still need to react to what the defense shows you and then make your move. This is the right move. This is the right move now. And 4 years of college is a great plan for basically anybody. But you're not just anybody. You are the greatest collegiate talent I have ever seen shoot, dribble, pass, and defend a basketball my entire time on this great planet Earth. Now, Miss Martha, Mr. Pete, I have seen so many of the greats jump right from high school to the pros. Freak, you've at least experienced college. You know what that is. You've been there. You've done that. I am offering you now a chance at the experience of a lifetime. Do you know how many people would love to be in those Jordans right now?
Yeah, Freak, I mean, what if you get hurt? You remember how you came down on your ankle in that game earlier this year?
Oh, yeah, but I was nothing.
Right, we know it was nothing, but next time it could be something.
I saw that. Good game, but bam! Just like that, and you could be flipping burgers. Well, maybe not flipping burgers. Maybe you're the manager or assistant manager at some burger joint. Maybe I do a favor and make a call, and you're a delivery boy at Sal's Famous Pizzeria. But the bottom line is, you will be a long, long, long ways away from signing multi-million dollar contracts with me, Dom Pagnotti, as your agent.
So it's all about the money, right?
When was it not all about the money?
Money isn't everything.
No, it isn't, sir, and no disrespect was meant. But freak, money is freedom. The freedom of choice, the freedom to live. Money is the difference between renting and owning, between being the waiter and being waited on. It's the difference between being the chauffeur or being chauffeured. Now, do you want to be a chauffeur? This here is a contract. This makes me your agent. Sign on the dotted line, and I will take you and your family to the promised land.
Like I said, Mr. Pagnotti, it's not all about the money.
Pete, let the man finish.
He made his point. He's finished. Aren't you finished?
I said my piece, but I know I'm right. You guys should talk.
Pete, what if Frequency does get hurt? Shouldn't he take this opportunity now?
What if the boy goes pro, gets hurt, and then doesn't have a college degree? Look how hard we work for him to get to where he is.
But college isn't for everybody. Pete, you didn't go.
That's why we worked so hard for him.
Just saying. I mean, if he's ready to do this now as opposed to later, Pete, anything can happen.
You're right. Anything could happen. This is his future. This
is
his life.
You're not listening to me, Pete.
Not just a game.
All right. Mom, Pops. It's all right. Look, truth be told, I don't even know what I want to do right now.
I understand that.
Yeah, but I was talking to my boy Vic the other day.
Why?
And he was making a lot of sense. He thinks I should leave early, too.
You know what? I've kept quiet this whole time, and I also think that Freak should join the league. I think it's a great business decision, and I think that Mr. Pagnotti is absolutely right.
Thank you, Yvette.
You're welcome.
Now, Freak, I know for a fact that people have been talking about the company you keep, and you need to be careful. It could compromise what we're trying to do here.
What are you trying to say?
You know, your association with that guy Victor off the court, it could compromise your selection in a draft. As a matter of fact, I know it will. Do you realize the difference in dollars between being drafted first overall and 21st? You're talking tens of millions of dollars. You don't get it, do you? CeCe, our first sneaker deal alone, you're talking a difference of a $50 to $100 million difference just by that. Number one, that's what we need. If I were not 1,000% convinced in my mind and in my heart that we could get you drafted first overall, I wouldn't be like this. This is the play. This is the move, Freak. You got to listen to me.
I absolutely hear you, but who are they to tell me who I can't hang with my brother?
No, Freak, you need to listen to him. I've been telling you the same exact thing.
Mr. Dom, Frequency and Victor grew up together. They're best friends. We took the boy in and practically adopted him.
Martha, I told you that boy ain't nothing but trouble.
He's family.
Okay, but that's my boy, and he agrees with y'all.
It's not about agreeing with Vic. We're trying to prepare you for your future.
You know, but it is his future.
This is none of your business.
You still have a decision to make. Sign with me, yes or no.
Can I just interrupt for one sec? Everybody just settle down, please. Now, I appreciate you all taking the time in this heated discussion, but the truth of the matter is, there's only one person in the room that can make this decision. Now, son, you know how I feel.
Right.
Education is the most important thing in life, but this is your choice. It's not your mother's or your sister's or mine. It's not your girlfriend. It's not Mr. Pagnotti's. And it definitely ain't Victor's. This is your decision, son. So you tell us what you want to do.
I need 30 seconds, Freak. Okay. I have four beautiful children, and I want each of them to go to college and graduate. But if you walked up to any one of those four children right now and said, I will give you a contract that's worth $100, $200, $300 million, I would say, bypass college. You can always go back. I want you to graduate. I want you to get your doctorate. I want to call you Dr. Freak. But you need to understand this. Now, you can go all over this beautiful country that we live in and go into any of the major universities. You will find people that are 30, 40, 50, 60, say 80 years old, and you will find them graduating. But if you live to be 500 years old, you will never see ever, ever somebody 40, 50, 60 years old being drafted from college into the NBA. We need to strike while the iron is hot. This is your life. We will get you drafted first overall. You will be up there with all the big names. I'm not talking first rounder. I'm talking first overall. Listen to me. This is what I do. I am the best at what I do. Nobody is better.
You have had your 30 seconds plus.
Miss Martha, I am sorry. You just need to understand.
Would you please let my wife speak?
I apologize.
Frequency. Baby, what do you want to do?
Okay. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to have CeCe go through this contract front to back. I'm going to think about it, sleep on it, pray on it, and I will call you in the morning.
All right. Listen, Mr. Pete, Miss Martha, it was a pleasure meeting the two of you over telephone, and I look forward to meeting you both in person. Remember, everybody, this meeting never took place. We weren't even here. Capiche?
Capiche.
Okay.
All right, Mom, Pops, I'm gonna call you guys later. I love you.
Love you,
son. Love you too, son. Bye.
We met working at the post office together. Martha was a clerk and I was a carrier. And I asked her out to lunch one time and take her for a bagel around the corner from where we worked.
A bagel?
A bagel, yeah.
A cream cheese?
Cream cheese.
Split down the middle?
Split down the middle. Love at first sight.
Yeah?
I believe that. It was true. It happened to me.
Good evening and welcome to the NBA Draft. With the first pick in the NBA draft, the Minnesota Timberwolves select Karl Anthony Towns from the University of Kentucky. With the second pick in the NBA draft, the Los Angeles Lakers select D'Angelo Russell from The Ohio State University. With the third pick in the NBA draft, the Philadelphia 76ers select
Jahlil Okafor from Duke University.
With the fourth pick in the NBA draft, the New York Knicks select
Kristaps Porzingis
from Latvia.
With the fifth pick in the NBA draft, the Orlando Magic select
Mario Hezonja from Dubrovnik, Croatia.
With the sixth pick in the NBA draft, the Sacramento Kings select
Willie Cauley-Stein from the University of Kentucky.
With the seventh pick in the NBA draft, the Denver Nuggets select
Emmanuel Mudiay
from Dallas, Texas. With the eighth pick in the NBA draft, the Detroit Pistons select
Stanley Johnson from the University of Arizona.
With the ninth pick in the NBA draft, the Charlotte Hornets select
Frank Kaminsky
from the University of Wisconsin. With the 10th pick in the NBA draft, the Miami Heat select
Justice Winslow from Duke University.
With the 11th pick in the NBA draft, the Indiana Pacers select
Miles Turner from the University of Texas.
With the 12th pick in the NBA draft, the Utah Jazz select
Trey Lyles from the University of Kentucky.
With the 13th pick in the NBA draft, the Phoenix Suns select
Devin Booker from the University of Kentucky.
With the 14th pick in the NBA draft, the Oklahoma City Thunder select
Cameron Payne
from Murray State University. With the 15th pick in the NBA draft, the Atlanta Hawks select
Kelly Oubre
from the University of Kansas. With the 16th pick in the NBA draft, the Boston Celtics select
Terry Rozier from University of Louisville.
With the 17th pick in the NBA draft, the Milwaukee Bucks select
Rashad Vaughn from UNLV.
With the 18th pick in the NBA draft, the Houston Rockets select
Sam Decker
from the University of Wisconsin. With the 19th pick in the NBA draft, the Washington Wizards select
Jaren Grant
from the University of Notre Dame. With the 20th pick in the NBA draft, the Toronto Raptors select
Delon Wright from the University of Utah.
With the 21st pick in the NBA draft, the Dallas Mavericks select
Justin Anderson from the University of Virginia.
With the 22nd pick in the NBA draft, the Chicago Bulls select
Bobby Portis
from the University of Arkansas. With the 23rd pick in the NBA draft, the Portland Trailblazers select
Ronde Hollis Jefferson from the University of Arizona.
With the 24th pick in the NBA draft, the Cleveland Cavaliers select
Tyus Jones from Duke University.
With the 25th pick in the NBA draft, the Memphis Grizzlies select
Darrell Martin from Louisiana State University.
With the 26th pick in the NBA draft, the San Antonio Spurs select John Brown from UCLA. With the 27th pick in the NBA draft, the Los Angeles Lakers select
Larry Nance Jr.
With the 28th pick in the NBA draft, the Boston Celtics select the 19-year-old power forward from the University of Kansas.
Let's do this, young man.
Yes, sir.
Wow, that's efficient. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Frequency Vibration. Welcome aboard, young man.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome aboard.
Wow. Wow. This is bananas.
Take your time, baby.
Thanks, Ma. Okay, so I first want to thank everyone who made this possible. Mom, Dad, I couldn't have done this without you. I'd like to thank my lady Yvette. My dude Vic.
Hey, yo, I got you, man. Hey, all them in the building all day, yo. All
right.
I love you, man. I love you in town.
He's like my brother. Oh, gosh. And also, want to thank my sister, Cece, who is also my manager. Swish. Love you.
I love you more.
And my agent, Mr. Don Pagnotti himself.
You're the man, baby.
I guess I will take some questions now. Yes, ma'am.
How did you get the nickname Freak?
A lot of people don't know this, but Freak is short for my very first nickname, Frequency Vibrations.
Yeah, true story. I'd like to introduce our mother so she could tell it.
Go ahead. You know,
Mama.
Tell her, Mama.
No, Mama. Come on,
Mama. Go get her, Mama.
Thank you, everyone. Frequency and Cece are fraternal twins. And so when I was pregnant, one of them kept kicking and jumping around all the time. So my husband, Pete, put headphones on my belly and played reggae music.
Hence the name Frequency Vibrations.
We shortened it to Freak.
How did you know who was kicking?
A mother knows. A mother always knows.
Are you ready for a photo op?
Yes. All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the next NBA superstar, Frequency Vibration.
Go ahead, son.
Thank you all for coming. We will be available for one-on-ones in the back.
Thank you.
Good job. Well done.
Congratulations, son.